Welcome to this How to Create Bracket Transfer Media training video. My name is Henrik and I'm joined today by my colleague Tim. Hello Tim.
Hey.
So Tim, what is bracket transfer media exactly?
Well, when we look at the bracket treatments, in the old days you would see the brackets one after one directly in the patient's mouth. But that's very time consuming and also not accurate enough. So when we talk about indirect bonding, we need a way to transfer the bracket positions that are set digitally in the software.
Yep.
So it actually ends up in the right position in the patient's mouth.
Sounds like a good idea.
Yeah. It also means that you'll be able to maybe delegate this to some of your assistants, depending on which country you're in. There are different legislations on that, depending on the country you're in. But that could be a possibility in
yep.
some countries. It offers a very high range of flexibility. So if we look at what we call markers, I'll get back to that, but that's a way where you can find a way to represent where the real bracket should be placed later on a model you thermoformed on top of.
Okay, but you will show that later.
Definitely, yep. Yeah. But there you have a very high flexibility when it comes to which printers can support it. We have another method where you can disable the need for silicone drops. Also, that will be evident once I demo it. And finally, we have a way where you can circumvent the entire printing of models and no wear compressing, of course, of these models
okay.
not being involved.
All right. So can you take us quickly through what we'll learn in this video?
Sure. We will learn to make these traditional models that you use as a basis for your wear compressing. And also we will learn how to make a directly printed transfer tray that would circumvent these previously mentioned elements. And then we will also look at what possibilities we have to adjust the designs to meet the requirements from various machinery and materials. So depending on what printer you have and what materials you put on it, then our software can support that.
Okay.
And then also finally to be able to get your designs out in a format that you can actually put into a machine.
Exactly. All right. Thanks, Tim. Okay, let's have a look at how it works. Okay, so we are now in Appliance Designer, and for those of you that have watched the first video on bracket placement, you notice that was in OrthoAnalyzer. So once that case was validated, then the actual bracket transfer happens in Appliance Designer. So Tim, why don't you show us how it works?
Sure. This is then, as Henrik mentioned, a validated case. If it wasn't validated, then we won't even be able to see the brackets inside Appliance Designer.
Right.
So what we'll do now is that we will right-click on it, and then we'll go down and choose to make a new appliance. We could change the naming here, but other than that, we'll just go on and press Create here. Now we can actually see here in the lower left corner that it's loading the brackets, and if it wasn't validated, then that wouldn't happen.
Yep.
Then it will ask us if we will load the occlusion from OrthoAnalyzer, and we will do that. It could have been that there were collisions. In fact, we can see this is the case where some of the brackets on the mandibula is colliding with the maxillary, and maybe we've saved another occlusion to circumvent that, and now we could load that occlusion.
Okay, I saw that quickly there.
Yeah,
okay.
it opened that a little,
nice.
So there's
nice.
No intersection. It will be up for the doctor to decide, but the software supports this. So now we need to make some transfer media, and we will start with the basic stuff as is used today in indirect bonding, and that is where we generate a model where you vacuum compress on top of it.
And okay, so you just right click basically here and choose master model.
Yeah. So if we start with the upper, then right click and choose indirect bonding master model. And we will press okay. We could change the colors and all the usual settings that the users are used to from Appliance Designer.
Right.
So let's start with the most simple one, and this is what we call markers. And the idea is here that we will print the model as seen here, but without the brackets, and instead there will be these tiny walls where the real bracket should be placed before we do the vacuum compressing. We will then still, of course, need to protect the hooks and wings like you usually do in the real life workflow once this had been printed. So I'll start the generation of these while we talk about the parameters that we have that can help us with the production equipment and materials.
Yep.
The first parameter is called inner surface offset. And what that does is that it on purpose either make the footprint of the bracket too big or too small. So if we have some frictions issues or other things, then we could circumvent them by making inner wall too big and too small. So in essence, it's how too big or too small, depending if you make this as a plus or a minus value.
Yeah,
you can see it's in fact done already computing this, and this is fully automatic depending on what bracket library you have chosen. The next one, the next two one with the wall width and height, that is the width.
You can almost guess what that does.
Yeah. Maybe a quick word on what they are used for. Especially the height could be useful, because if we have a bracket with a very low profile, where maybe the wings are very close to the tooth surface, then maybe we will need to reduce the height of the balls here to make sure that they don't collide.
Yeah.
And you can set them parametrically down here. But other than that, as you can see now, that one is ready to export, and then we could print this, put the brackets in, protect the wings and hooks by silicone, and then vacuum compress our thermoform on top of that.
Okay.
So that's sort of the basic one.
Yeah.
So let's look at some of the more fun advanced one.
Okay.
So the next one of the transfer methods we will look into now here today, that is what we call containers. That is also something that you can thermoform on top of. So we will make this indirect bonding master model as before. But instead, we will choose containers, the container option. So we will have it start doing its processing while I explain what the various options these parameters are for.
Yep.
The first one is called inner surface offset as in markers, and it's essentially the same thing. On purpose, you can make these containers, as we call them, either too big or too small. A container is a bracket representation, but with one noticeable difference, and that is that all the undercuts are removed. And by undercuts, I mean in relation to the insert direction of the bracket into the vacuum form the transfer tray.
Okay.
So if we look at this bracket, then you know the cavities here under the wings, material will fill that out, and the same with the hook, that would be supported by material underneath.
Okay.
This inner surface offset will make it either too big or too small. Now it's actually done with the calculation, so maybe it's a bit more evident what I meant by me.
Now I see exactly what you meant. Yeah, yeah.
The next one is called blockout angle. And what it does is that it makes the walls tapered of these of this material that has been added. So if we increase the angle here, the blockout angle, then it will sort of angle out. And that is to accommodate friction questions.
Right.
So if the material is very hard or just have a high inherent friction, then we can either make the walls tapered or make this entire container a bit smaller.
Mm.
Retention amount is actually a pretty cool feature. If you remember how the original hook looked, then of course there was a ball and a small pin going in here. If we add a retention amount, then it will reintroduce a little of the cavity that has now been filled out by this material.
Right. And why would you want to do that?
When you then vacuum-press your tray on top of this, and you have a little retention, then you will get this clicking effect when you click in the bracket into the finished transfer.
Sort of like a tactile feel.
So you get a sensation, and now it's fully seated, because you know if you don't get the click, then it's not seated all the way to the bottom.
Yeah, makes sense.
So that makes it very secure for both the lab and clinic to know that it's seated properly. The last parameter is called prolongation length. And what that does is that it takes care of any cavities that are under the bracket base and the tooth surface. Sometimes the bracket will rest on only 3 or 4 points on the tooth surface, and there might be a little hole underneath. And this prolongation length will sort of extend the bracket base into the tooth according to this parameter. So if we have a patient with some very thinly worn incisors, then maybe we need to reduce this to 0.5 millimeters or another value.
Yep.
But this default value, we haven't found a case yet where it doesn't catch it, but it's up for the users to know that they can change it if they find the need. So that is sort of how you would make this model here with containers.
Okay.
And the really nice part of this is that now you don't have to waste time to protect the hooks and wings with silicone drops. you thermoform on top of this, and then it's ready to insert the brackets right away and then seat them in the mouth.
Yeah. Plus the two workflow you just showed are really, really easy to use and understand.
The final transfer option we have is directly printed trays. It would be really cool if you didn't have to, first of all, print this entire model. It's, you use a lot of material and time on that. And then you had to vacuum press a tray on top of this and then spend the time to cut it out afterwards. It would be really cool if we could print the transfer trays directly. And we have made a design option, so this is in fact possible. And the only thing we need is a short-term biocompatible material to print the transfer tray in.
Yeah.
There are materials on the way, and they should be on the market within a few months. So when you hear this video, there's a good chance that the materials are already there. So contact your FreeShape reseller and have them inquire at FreeShape for the latest updates.
So that's quite a game changer for indirect bonding.
Definitely.
Yeah. Okay.
People seems really excited about that with the people that we have shown this so far.
Yep.
But let's try to make this directly printed transfer tray. So we still need this, but this is only for a basis to design the transfer tray on top of. So we will choose this, right click, and then choose create shell. And now we will then choose the insert direction. And that is not the insert direction for the individual brackets. That's the insert direction for the overall transfer tray.
Right.
And this looks fine, but we could adjust it if we wanted to.
Yep.
Set a different camera angle, press set insert direction, and then the insert direction will be adjusted to the camera view. But we will accept this one.
Yep.
So with the insert direction properly set, now we need to trace where we want the transfer tray to go.
Right.
And we would like the transfer tray to grip around as much as possible of the brackets, but at the same time allow it to escape once we remove the transfer tray from the patient's mouth.
Yeah, because it obviously needs to come off.
Exactly. Yeah. So if we have an open space here towards the gingival edge of the transfer tray, then the bracket will be able to escape once we pull out the transfer tray in the direction of the insert direction here. So I suggest we try tracing it along the bracket edge here.
Yeah.
So that would be the lower edge of the transfer tray.
Yep.
I won't do the entire
tray. No, just do three or four.
Exactly.
Or,
you'll get the idea.
Yeah.
So now we will, otherwise we've done it all the way around, but now we will just go in and make the other edge of the transfer tray here. This would be a fairly soft material. In fact, we've seen prototypes already, and it's sort of a hard rubber property, so it seems ideal for this.
Okay.
So we could even make it grip around some undercuts here on the backside, and it will still be able to let go.
Yep.
So we will go around here, and then we will close the spine here.
Yeah.
Now we could correct any mistakes, maybe move them around a little. If you made big mistakes, we could choose to do a fast edit session and then just sort of draw like with a pencil, and then it will adjust them.
Yeah.
But let's try to see what we have so far. So now it's done with the computations here, and
I see. Yeah.
It looks good.
Yeah.
As you can see, it looks like the brackets
would come off.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And it's still hugging the brackets one to one.
Yeah.
One thing that we could have adjusted here with this one is to make it of various thickness. We have the possibilities to decide how thick they should be.
Okay.
The default setting is 1 millimeter, but we could have made it thicker if we felt that was appropriate for the material.
Mm.
If it is rubber, then you need some thickness for it, so maybe a millimeter and a half or 2 millimeters.
Yeah.
But again, it depends on the material, and in our software, you have the possibility to adjust it.
Yeah.
If this material was a little bit too stiff, then maybe we would like to make it a bit more flexible, and we have the possibility to do that. So if we choose, we click first on the shell here, and then we press modify model. Then we have a tool where we can make thinner areas on the shell, so hopefully it will be able to flex around these edges. So you choose this reduce thickness tool, and then you simply just click along the line where you want it to be thinner. So maybe along the incisal edge here. Once you've clicked on the last point, then you double click on it, and then it will visualize this.
So create a tube of sorts.
Yeah, and that would be subtracted. Sometimes if you don't put enough control points, then it will tunnel inside the model. Then you will just grab one of these control points and make sure that it goes outside the model again here.
Yes.
Once you are certain that it's outside here, then you just press play, and now it will subtract this tube from the model. You can define the radius here.
Ah, clever. So now I can, of course, bend more easily around that.
Yeah, that's, of course, the idea, but that will be material dependent, but we just have made the tool available for you so you can use it. Maybe we wanted to make one here, but you get the idea.
Yep.
If we had, in fact, made this transfer tray along the entire arch, then probably we would want to seat it in sections. Maybe we want to seat this section in one go, and this in one go, and this in one go.
So make jigs, basically.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we could cut it up, and I'll demonstrate this function that does this. So we have this cut model function, and what it does is that you can simply draw where you want to cut it. You don't even have to let go. You can simply just drag it around like this.
Okay.
So now we could have cut it up in the relevant places.
Yeah.
Press play, and then it will start cutting it up in the sections we have chosen. It's also possible to choose straight lines, and you can also define how thick the knife should be, so to speak.
Yep.
It's already done now, so we'll press done, and then we will turn off the original design element, and now we can turn these off individually, and they are ready for seating.
Very clever.
If we turn on the grid here, you can see that this is ready for a printer out of the box. I mean, it's a good, nice mesh as usual, so you should be able to produce this right away.
Impressive.
Yeah. So this sort of concludes the transfer methods, and we feel especially the last one here would really be something that our users would like. Yeah.
Okay, thank you for taking us through this, Tim. This concludes this training video. Make sure to check out the other videos in the series, and thank you for watching.